Every civilization has a locus, and we have disempowered ourselves by shifting the locus to an imagined class of experts. We have an incredibly peculiar version of how the universe is put together. First of all, we rely a lot of the time on the notion of the insi-binsi, genes, viruses, atoms, elementary particles. These are the things which shape our world. We tell each other, and yet who has ever seen any of these things? I mean, a virus, maybe a few people have seen. A hydrogen atom, it's a pretty airy-fairy concept. And when you start talking about the anti-new meson and stuff like that, where you can only approach it through an arcane mathematical language, the reality, whatever that means, of these things becomes pretty questionable. See, one of the things I think that psychedelics could do is give back to us what I call the immediacy of felt experience. Since the rise of Cartesian analysis in the 17th century, everything that we experience has been defined as what are called secondary characteristics. Color, a secondary characteristic. Feeling, and what's real is mass, momentum, charge, spin, stuff like this, which, you know, these are the primary qualities of the universe. Whoever encounters or deals with them, we need to model reality so that it is understandable to us. I mean, that statement should even have to be made shows how far off track we are. Our current model of reality is excellent for describing the behavior of hydrogen at the center of stars or something like that. Terrible for explaining to you how you're supposed to stay tuned to your girlfriend. So somehow we have sold out to abstraction. And this is something about science, you know, and the demonic power of numerical analysis and stuff like this. I think that part of what the psychedelic revolution is and why it is so politically threatening is because a psychedelic person does not believe anything they cannot confirm for themselves through thought, intuition, or feeling. And a non-psychedelic person joins up with the quantum physicists or the Hasidic Jews or some group of people who've already got it packaged and figured out. I mean, the UFO thing is a good example. Everybody's interested in UFOs and, you know, are there space people, are there not? And I think most people think that the news will come, that the way you encounter a UFO, the way most of us will encounter a UFO, is that the president will call a press conference and say, you know, that the time has come to speak frankly about certain declassified material and that, yes, in fact, it has been going on. I mean, that's not how it's going to happen. The way it's going to happen is on 5 grams in silent darkness in your living room, and that's real. You know, if flying saucers were to land on the south lawn of the White House tomorrow, it would be minor news compared to what can happen to you a minute and a half after smoking DMT. We don't realize that we are not real unless we are the center of our own private mandala. And so we look to media, to experts. You know, maybe the Dalai Lama can clarify it, or Mother Teresa, or Stephen Hawking. Well, forget all that. Those are just linguistic concepts as far as you're concerned. The only thing that's real to you is yourself and your immediate surroundings. And if we could empower that, you know, our political problems would disappear overnight. We are infantile and we do love it. We don't really try to claim our existential validity. And those who do are called mad, because they depart from the sanctioned paradigm.